We've learned of verbs being classified as main verb, auxiliary verb, transitive and intransitive verb. And here in this video, we will do another classification of verbs, and that is finite and non-finite verbs. Now, a verb is either finite or non-finite. A finite verb is a main verb which agrees with the subject, with the tense, etc. Whereas the non-finite verb is of three types, that is the infinitive, gerund, and participle. And the participle again is of three types, that is the present participle, past participle, and perfect participle. So this is the classification of verbs on the basis of them being finite or non-finite. What are finite verbs? Finite verbs are those which show agreement with the subject and are marked for tense. A finite verb will change according to the tense, that means the past, present, or future tense. The finite verb will change according to person, first person, second person, or third person. For example, I and we are the first person. When you talk to someone else, that is you, becomes the second person. And when I am talking to you about someone else, he or she or they are in the third person. A finite verb will also change according to number, meaning singular or plural, one leaf and many leaves. Let us see how finite verbs change according to tense. He watches TV every day. He watched TV yesterday, and he will watch TV tonight. He is the subject, watches in the present tense, watched in the past tense, and will watch in the future tense. And so you see the main verb changing according to tense. Let us take another example. She is singing her favorite song. So now sing becomes is singing, present progressive tense. She had sung. Had sung is past perfect tense. And she sings her favorite song, simple present tense. So you see the verb sing changing according to tense. So that is how finite verbs, they change or modify themselves according to the tense. Now let us see how finite verbs modify or change themselves according to person, first person, second person, and third person. Now, I eat pizza every day. He eats pizza. Now see the verb being modified or changed according to first person, third person. They eat pizza every day. So we have in the first person uses I and me, or we and us. Okay, so when we talk about the first person, I, me, we, us, it's all about us. Okay, second person is you, and even in the plural it is you. The third person, we use words like he, she, it, and in the plural they and them. Finite verbs changing according to number, that is singular or plural. Let us check out some examples. This boy plays in the classroom. One boy plays in the classroom. But these boys, plural, play in the classroom. So you see the finite verb changing according to singular and plural. One more example. The apple is green. One apple is green. Many apples or those apples are green. Again, the verb changing according to number, that is singular and plural. The blue cup is empty. One cup. Whereas those blue cups are empty. Now that I've explained to you what finite verbs are like, let us see what non-finite verbs are. A non-finite verb cannot serve as the main verb in any independent clause or sentence. This means that a non-finite verb is not an action verb. It also doesn't have a tense. The sentence may be in the past, present, or future tense, but the non-finite verb itself is a neutral verb. So what can we pick out from this sentence? That a non-finite verb is not a main verb. It also means that it's not an action verb. And it also means that it does not have a tense. Now let us see how. I like swimming. Okay. Now, the action in this sentence is that the person likes. Okay. So like here is the main or the finite verb. Okay. We have another word here, swimming, which if I ask you, what is the verb? You'll immediately tell me swimming. But is the person swimming? No. No action is being done. The action here is like. So like is the finite verb and swimming, which is not an action, but it looks like a verb, is the non-finite verb. Now, Raj likes to go swimming. Okay. So here again, Raj, the action that Raj does is to like. And he likes again swimming. So swimming is not the action verb here. Swimming is the non-finite verb. Non-finite verbs, as I told you before, are of three types. Those are gerunds, participles, and infinitives. Now, gerunds act as nouns. They are ing words. Like in the previous sentence, I told you, I like swimming. What do I like? I like, action word is like, but I like something. What is that something? Swimming. And swimming is an ing word acting as a noun, therefore it is a gerund. Reading is my hobby, again ing noun, which is a gerund. Sam was bad at gardening. Gardening again is a gerund. Participles. Now, participles may be ing words, but they don't act as nouns but as adjectives. They act as describing words. The man sitting there is my uncle. Is the main verb. What describes the man? The word sitting. It's an ing verb. So therefore, the action is not sitting. It just describes the man there, and that is a participle. Here again, ing verb describing the athlete. Main verb is gets. So the action of describing an ing verb is known as a participle. If you need to know more about participles, you can watch my video on participles only. Infinitives, they are the base forms of the verb preceded by to. For example, base forms are run, play, sing, allow, climb, etc. So when we have the base form of the verb, here mean is convince and love, preceded by to. To comes before it. That is called an infinitive. I was able to convince him of our plan. The main verb being I was able. To know me is to love me. Okay, to know is an infinitive, to love is an infinitive. And if you look at These three, gerunds, participles and infinitives, the non-finite verbs, you will see that they don't change themselves according to tense, according to person and according to number.